In het coupling, we're going to couple a terminal alkene to an alkenyl or an aryl halide in the presence of a palladium catalyst and a base such as triethylamine. The reason we need that base in there is because the proton that gets replaced during the coupling reaction is this proton trans to any group that's attached to our alkene, and it's going to combine with the halide that's attached to the coupled group that we see here, and it's going to actually eliminate an HBr molecule or an hydroiodic or chloric, depending on which leaving group that we're coupling group that we use there on our alkenyl or aryl halide, and that's a strong acid that we're going to have to take care of during the reaction catalytic cycle. And so this amine will perform an acid-base reaction with that produced equivalent and eliminate it from the reaction mixture. Ultimately, though, we get our coupled alkene at the end, and we can match those groups up. So what are our limitations? Well, we just said we'd like a terminal alkene, and the less substituents, the better, because sterics really slow down this reaction. In fact, coupling of ethylene gas is the fastest, and anytime we add groups larger than that, it slows down. So this form that we've shown here is the best option. Now, we can speed up the reaction if we make R an electron withdrawing group. And electron withdrawing groups are going to have an electronegative atom on a functional group, but also a pi bond next door. So something like a ketone next door would allow for the withdrawing of the pi electrons in a kind of a resonance type condition so that we accentuate this dipole moment here in the molecule, within this molecule. And so that accelerates the reaction. Any group that can do that is a group that we'd like to have attached to this alkene. So we've got groups like nitro groups, NO2, that are going to have this general form. We've got esters that have this general form. We might have cyano groups as well. Okay, so anything that has this pi bond next door to our alkene is going to be a good electron withdrawing group to accelerate the Heck reaction. Now, our limitations on the halide are, well, we just said alkenyl halide, so we'd like to see something like this perhaps as our group. So this would be an alkenyl that could couple, or we could have an aryl or heteroaryl group that could couple as well. So either one of these guys would work for our coupling halide. So we've got a couple of advantages here. For lack of more room, let's put it right here. Our advantage here is that we have no need of a special reagent. You know, this is kind of like Gilman reagents or Suzuki coupling. We don't need a special reagent like an organoborane. We just need the alkene. The downside is no alkyl coupling option is available to us because of an elimination reaction that can occur in the presence of these alkyl groups, and the fact that alkanes are not active to the catalytic cycle. So we've got some advantages, but we've got a little disadvantage as well to the Heck reaction. Very easy to perform compared to a Gilman type reaction, Suzuki being one of the most versatile, but it does require the use of an organoborane reagent. All right, so again, we're considering a few things, including that the existing group that's on our alkene is going to be trans to whatever coupled group we have. That's why we drew our groups at the top in this fashion. We made sure to put our existing group on our alkene to make sure that it was trans to the coupled group. So we want that arrangement to be true. However, if we perform this reaction with A halide that has stereochemistry, such as this reaction, okay, we're going to retain the stereochemistry about the halide. So we've got a cis here, and so what we're going to end up with, if we put our catalyst in and our triethylamine and we run this reaction, well, this reaction is going to end up giving us a group that is trans to our alkene, but the stereochemistry of the halide group remains the same. So what we've got here, this cis arrangement remains the same, and yet we're still trans to the original. Remember, the couple proton is going to be the trans couple proton here, and we're going to stay trans in that arrangement after our coupling. Okay, so a couple stereochemistry things to consider when it's an alkenyl group. We know we've got to have our catalyst. We know we've got to have our base that can quench this formed strong acid. We said triethylamine is a great option. We can use that. The mechanism is an extended cycle, so check your class notes and what we say in class about how much of that mechanism we've got to know. I'll consider that a separate topic here as this video goes out into perpetuity. Check your class notes to see what we're doing in a particular semester. And one thing that we've already said, but we'll reiterate here, is that our less sterically hindered alkenes are going to react fastest. But we can boost the speed if we have an electron withdrawing group on that alkene that is our major reactant of the Heck reaction. So let's look at a couple of examples here of what we can do with the Heck reaction. And so suppose we have an alkene that does have an electron withdrawing group like this ester. Okay, Heck reaction is stable to many functional groups that we've studied, including acidic functional groups and electron withdrawing functional groups, unlike the Grignard or the organolithium. We can then react it with a halide. Let's say, what if we had an aryl type halide here? We just drop our catalyst in, palladium, two ligands. The ligands can vary, and so for your prep, it could be one of several things, as long as we've got our catalyst there. And then again, triethylamine. Can be abbreviated capital T, capital E, capital A, or you can draw out the molecular formula like we did above. And so in the presence of that catalyst, we're going to get coupling, but we're going to remember that this original group, we're coupling onto the trans position, and so then we can abbreviate with our phenyl ring, PH, there, or we can draw in the benzene ring, which has coupled on where the iodine used to be. We can also have, let's do another one here. What if we had a cyano group? So that'd be fairly rapid as well. There's a triple bond there that can electron withdraw onto that nitrogen. Let's do a bromide here onto this alkene. And we could have, let's say, an ethyl group on the other side. Okay, same catalyst. Same base here to mop up our excess HBr that we're going to form. We formed hydroiodic acid in the previous example. Let's draw that in right quick. We had hydroiodic acid with that triethylamine. Then with its lone pair, grab the proton off of that hydroiodic acid. We could even draw out that bond to make sure we're being clear there. Okay, so what have we got? Mechanistically, we are soaking up this extra acid to keep the catalytic cycle going to form an iodide and a protonated amine there. Okay, so just as an aside. Now, again, completing our line reaction, we're going to have stability to the cyano group. Very versatile reaction. Coupling to that transposition. We note that we have a trans stereochemistry in our alkene, and so we've got to keep that arrangement as we couple on, so we end up with two trans double bonds after our Heck reaction.